Hello there. In this video, I am going to show you the basics of an activity diagram. Let's start with the stencil. If you see, this is the UML 2.2 symbol, which is stencil. You can get this thing from Googling the net if you do not have it. And the other thing is that if you say use case, US unit, this comes with the Microsoft Visio. And let's move to the other things like that you get it. These things also come with that thing, with the visual, and also this one. However, what is important is that we are going to use. You can use both of them together also, no problems, by dragging some of the from the visual stencil and some from UML 2.2 stencil, no problems. However, this UML 2.2 stencil that is available on the net is much more better to use. Okay, let me actually explain you some of the basics for the activity diagram. If you, whenever you start with the activity diagram, you start with the initial flow. That's the beginning. You actually can drag here, okay, and you have can change the to the final one, to the activity final. And if you are thinking what's the difference between the activity final and flow final? In an activity diagram, you can terminate the flow by many ends, and when you do it, you use this flow final for doing it. Otherwise, in most of the circumstances, you would be using the final flow, that is, let me go up here, that is, if you select the activity final, that is what it is, you know, and let me delete it. And this is called an action. If you see here, this is called an action. If you see, if you bring drag it here, it's called an action. You can drag it, and that is how it is. Just I will try to do actually delete it because it's not needed. And if you see, this is a flow, and this is what you are actually using it. You can actually change the depending upon what direction you want, you can use it, and you can also put something in the, if you want, if you can something add to something it, like something in the arrow, and it should be able to stick to it. Just double click it to the arrow and type something, whatever you want to it. And that's it. And then we have this fork. Basically, if you see, you know, in the fork and join is something it is actually used in the activity diagram, so that many options come from the single options, and then they can actually flow in different direction. Have a, just as you can see in this thing, this circumstances, they can go. And again, if you want to unite them back like that, let me put some action here, one action and another action, okay, and then you can again also again bring it back, and when you bring it back together, it is called a join. Let's see, let me show it to you. If you want to make it like that, I should be able to do it like that. And let's bring it here again. When you want to make it, now this is known as fork because it has come from the above, from the one direction, one action, and it is coming from the other action. And again when I want to join the this flow, I can use the arrow again and bring it down, and doing that thing, I can again still continue in the same below to the single action again. Here, as you can see, yeah, that's how it is done. So you can actually this when it comes to the top, it's known as fork. When you bring it, when it gets down, it's known as join, because a single action is going into two different ways, so it's called a fork, and when you bring it together again, it's called a join. So that being said, I should be now able to delete that thing. That being said, there are many other things in the activity diagram like swim lanes and other things that I would not be actually be using in this thing. This is called the decision or the march. You can see this is allows you to make the decision and come to the merge also, but however we are going to show it to you here, as you can see. And let's start with this activity diagram, and I'll just actually try to make this thing disappear. And you can see there's a start flow, beginning of the flow, and the basic action is going to be by UML software. So before we actually want to buy a UML software, we have to evaluate different software. So the evaluation software will take place, then depending upon what we want to buy, there will be technical aspect of evaluation. Technical aspect of the evaluation is being done. Okay, and that's the action. And now in that process, the three technical software has been evaluated, that is Visio, Power Designer, Spark. Let me again tell you, these are not the only software, there are many others, but for this example I have taken this thing. This is a three different software that has to be evaluated. These are going to evaluate Visio, evaluate Power Designer, evaluate Spark, and then which one to buy. Now comes the decision, is this the best one for our organization to buy? If it is yes, then it goes for the price aspect to the management. If it is no, it gets terminated here, and we are not interested. If it is not the best product for our organization, we have to choose one of them. And if it is yes, then it will go to the price management. Again, this is a decision being taken here. Again, if you go down here, if you see the whether this Power Designer is the best one to buy, if it is yes, then it goes for the privacy evaluation. If it's no, then again you can see that though it gets terminated, we are not interested in it. Again, let's go to the third one, Spark. Is this the best software for our organization to buy? If it is yes, it goes to the price aspect management, that price, whether the price actually is suitable for it. Then if it's no, then it goes and terminate, that's been terminated. Now whichever software actually goes to the price aspect, for the price aspect goes to the management. Okay, the management will evaluate whether it's affordable, and if not affordable, it's expensive, so it is cancelled. Then it gets terminated. Use the whiteboards instead of using the software because it's too expensive, and it gets terminated again. Again, if it's affordable, if the organization thinks that the software is good to buy, then it's affordable definitely, so it is approved, and then it's bought, and the buying decision is actually gets action gets activated, and then it's actually terminated. This is how you would actually use the activity. This is a very simple activity diagram, but normally it would become more complex. This is just using the fundamentals of the activity diagram. And you can see these are notes. You can drag the notes. Let me show it to you. If you see this is the notes, you can put it here. You can type here by typing it here. And that's it. And this is what is covered in this activity diagram. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.